to the top. Stop and hire me, please, oh please, oh please. Hiya, my name is Mocha, I am 19, I'm originally from Essex, but now I live in London. My drag name comes from my favourite coffee. I love white chocolate mocha specifically, but like the implications of being called white chocolate was a bit, you know. Common misconception is that like I'm always really nice, like I am actually quite shady. I stole a Kinder egg from the shops once and I got away with it, yeah. Popped it in my pocket and away I went. People sometimes think I'm really like intimidating, but I guess because the eye makeup is so huge. Yeah, I've been in music videos, but does that really count? Especially when you don't get paid. Pay your artists. People be like, oh, you're Mocha though. And I'm like, yeah. In and out of drag, I'm the same, except when I'm in drag, it gives me the permission to make the jokes that I want to make when I'm out of drag. My performance style is very fun, very quirky. I like to say that I'm camp and funny, but like, am I funny? We don't know. We're not quite sure yet. She's still developing. So we'll find out, I guess. Worst thing that's happened to me in drag is performing in front of the deadest crowd ever. No applause, make a joke, no laughter, ask a question, no response. My shoe flies off, it hits a fence, bounces back right into my eye. I had like a huge bump for days. I got a reel of it though, and it went kind of viral, so piss off basically. My edge in the competition is a right angle edge. I think that's a really good edge. It's not too obtuse. My drag represents nothing. My first ever performance was season 2 heat of the Gold Rush. I was like, I'm gonna win this thing, I'm hilarious. And I did not get through. So I was like, oh, I'll do the season 3 ones too. Oh, I love competitions. I get so competitive. I think that's like the Capricorn coming out of me. I don't know, I'm like, I'm not into star signs. I've just been told, so like, I'm gonna win the Gold Rush because I'm funny, I'm a meme, and I'm gorgeous. Mom. Season 3 is a season of f***ery.
Now I know what you're thinking. Greer on Beater sound like some 70s cop show, but I promise y'all, it's an instrument. And here, beating her Guero, is Mocha.
Hiya, I'm Mocha, I'm 19, and I'm originally from Essex, but now I live in London. Look-wise, I'm really into like big sleeves, and I love big silhouettes, and looking cute.
Aww. We're gonna hold it vertically, like this. Whether it's a drum, or maraca, or claves, or the Guero, it's the same stroke, it's just this up and down stroke. So this is key, and it's gonna make it a lot easier for you to play the Guero.
She's got the technique down right, but she needs to put a bit more passion into it, you know what I'm saying?
Hello, sexy, wanna meet? I'm top looking for smooth hairless bottom who is very experienced, but also very tight.
She might be a bottom, but she ain't smooth and hairless.
Grinder noise in a number, at this point, it is like the number one most overused, most generic thing. So I'm like, how are you gonna save it?
Meet now, question mark, question mark, question mark.
Rip for her pleasure. Ew.
My edge in the competition is definitely my makeup because I've seen everyone's makeup and it's okay. But it's not as good as mine. Let me have makeup at least, you know. Everyone else can have performing and shit. Let me have my looks.
So originally I auditioned for season 2 and I didn't make it past the heats, and then Taylor said that I should try again. So I auditioned for season 3 and I got in. So watch out.
Unfortunately for Mocha, they have ended up in our first ever showdown of the season, and both of them will have to perform the house down boots to stay in the competition. First up, Mocha.
All of this time I planned I'd be patient and you would love me again. You'd come to respect my mind, and at last you'd find you could love me again. And I have turned my whole world upside down, trying not to let you go. Watching you walk away is like a fatal blow.
Can't believe I'm in this position.
Channeling that queer energy from every glee club ever. Fantastic.
I'm very glad that I'm not in the bottom two.
I am so much better.
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 I am so much better
than before.
Looks amazing, and clearly I remember being there and just wanted it so much. You could feel the energy, so well done, awesome.
I feel like when you compare them, I won.
It is time for me to announce who has made it through to another week of the Gold Rush. And the judges have decided that there are an awful lot of letters in here. And it says, Mocha has made it through to another week of the competition, y'all! Up next is Mocha and Indy 9 getting inspired by Under the Sea icon SpongeBob and Patrick. I hope they won't be too crabby if they land in my bikini bottom this week.
Are y'all ready, kids?
Aye, aye, Captain!
I can't hear you!
I must preface this with, I've never seen an episode of SpongeBob in my life.
As a Capricorn and a control freak when it comes to like what I want to do, I had a hard time working together. I never showed that, at least I don't think I did. I mean, I might have come across as a bit cunty sometimes.
We rehearsed a lot for this. I remember during this bit, I had to tell Mocha so many times to stay still. But yeah, we got there in the end.
The next day.
Neck up, that was Mocha, but from the neck down, that's me. And you can tell I kind of look like this weird humanoid version of Patrick. And about an hour before I got on stage, I realized Patrick doesn't wear purple shorts, they're green.
8:01 p.m.
Oh, the magic conch shell!
What's that?
This!
Viva Mocha!
Shell knows all!
Oh, magic conch shell, what do we need to do
to win the gold rush?
Nothing.
The shell has spoken! Do you think she knows the Muffin Man song?
Just get out of here, you stupid dumb animal!
Where have I heard this before? Can I get 1 week, please, where someone doesn't do the same sound as me?
Well, obviously they copied us. Me and Pasta did it first, and then they probably went and added it to their number and then saved a new track. Is this the new Titanic gate? It might be. You'll build noise gate.
I don't like you.
I don't like you more!
I've never liked you!
And I 1,000 times never liked you!
Pink!
Yellow!
Round one, fight!
Realize that my tearaway shorts are just literally tearing at the seams.
Much, much, much later.
The pant reveal would have been more impressive if they didn't look like they were falling off halfway through the act.
I love Mocha's SpongeBob look, so on point, and actually they are a good pairing together, but I think doing SpongeBob and Patrick was like really tough.
Blowjob. She was actually quite adamant that that was included.
So this was when I did not know Indy at all, and like we're friends now and I love him, but I don't know, I struggled a bit.
I think you can tell which one of us is the lip syncer and which isn't. Mock is the lip syncer, just in case you didn't get that.
We went through it. No, we didn't go through it. We didn't go through it at all, but like I, in my head, was like, ugh, shut up. But I don't think that anymore. I love you, Indy, I'm sorry. I do love you. No, I sound so mean. I'm just being truthful. I'm a bad person, okay? I'm a bad person.
Is that how you want to end that? I'm a bad person?
I'm a bad person. We are SpongeBob and Patrick and, oh, careful with the pink, darling. Thank you. Yeah, we're like...
I'm a naked Patrick.
We're like opposites, you know.
Keep above the waist.
Cartoon couture, and then like, you know, a drag queen.
I have to give credit to Mocha for doing my face. I also think that deducted me points from the judges, but never mind.
I also think admitting that I didn't do as much of a mix deducted me from mine. I think it went fucking amazing.
For myself, well, I was nervous though, because I think before audience votes came in, I think I was in like the bottom two or three. So thanks, audience members, for saving my ass.
Yeah, it went really well. I'm not in the bottom two this time.
I mean, I agree with what... I was happy what Taylor said. I mean, she gave me a 100. I mean, I'm going to have words with the judge who gave me like a 60. But, you know, beauty's in the eye of the beholder.
I just want to know, Taylor. I can't do that accent. I want to know why this bitch got 100 and I've got 80.
Because if you've got it, you flaunt it.
No, you live under a rock. Like you don't even know the Never West Pride.
Listen, Diva. We all heard you vocalizing in the dressing room. Everyone knows you ain't singing this live. The question is, will Miss Mocha be a Michelle or a Beyonce?
Season 3 is going to be the season of fuckery.
I found out that Mocha was doing Beyonce with live vocals. Like, even I wouldn't be able to think of something to do with that. So, I'm curious to see what she's come up with.
Girls! We run this mother! Yeah! Girls! We run this mother! Yeah! Girls! We run this mother! Yeah! Girls! We run this mother! Girls! In the world! Girls! Who run the world? Girls! Who run the
world? Girls, stop. Stop! It's too much. It's too many times.
Girls. Who run the world? Girls. Who run this mother? 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 Girls. Who run the world? 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 Girls.
What's of that?
Girls. I mean, that was funny for like the first minute.
The thing about this number is that there's some very funny things that are used too much and then they become unfunny.
Yeah, it's bloody fantastic, isn't it?
She did her mic drop into her other hand.
I feel really bad for Mocha, I really do. She's doing a bad job, but most people probably would, apart from me, and that's okay.
Unfortunately for Mocha, they will have to face it off in the showdown tonight.
Yes, this is the Mocha I was looking for. This is Mocha to a T. Well, an M. Watching that.
Yeah, all I see is Beyonce still, because she's still in the same outfit, obviously. But this is good, yeah.
Real talk, she's very, very sexy. Sexy. Talented.
All right.
I'm sad, but I'm bad, because I was in the bottom two, but I got through. I'm a poet, and I didn't even know it. Beyonce. But you know, she's this something that she's called the bodysuit guy in the jacket. Does she wear jackets? I don't know. I don't listen to Beyonce. I'm very sorry. You know, I thought it was okay, but I kind of knew from when I did it as in the bottom two. That's fine. because like I turned it out in the lip sync. You know, I've sad superlatively go, I did cry. But you know, the game is the game. What's happened is happened, everything happens for a reason. I believe in my Lord Jesus Christ. Really I do. You know, the judges all work fair, you know, the criticisms I've got were good. But you know, I know where I can improve, you know. This isn't necessarily what I'm used to, so I went out of my comfort zone. I didn't do amazing, but that's all right, darling. That's all right. Thick thing.
Unlike our next diva, I do like it when someone takes my panties off and blows compliments up my butt. That's right, it's Miss Janelle Oberlin. Taking her on is Mocha, but the question is, phone or no phone?
Rise and shine.
Good morning, Slits.
Good morning, Chanel.
My name is Chanel Oberlin, and I am the queen of Kappa Kappa Tau.
I don't really have a persona. It's more just like, I don't really give a shit when I'm in drag. So yeah, I'm just me.
Mocha is looking so good in this outfit. This is a real step up considering she's been in the bottom.
Wow. Shut up! Shut up! That's a Mean Girls reference.
This is probably one of my favorite looks of Mocha. She looks great.
Welcome to the grind. What can I get started for you?
You don't want anything, do you? I'll have a Trenta, no foam, 5-shot, half cap, no foam, pumpkin spice latte with no foam at 210 degrees.
First of all, that's really hot. That's 2 degrees below boiling.
I'm sorry, did I enter a wormhole to a universe where this coffee house does not possess the technology to heat my favorite autumnal tradition to 210 degrees?
I wonder if Mocha wants to make that coffee order a meal deal by having some pasta with it.
Ew!
I'm living, but I hope she takes the shades off soon because I want to see her beautiful beat. I can't see it.
I like my pumpkin spice lattes extra hot, so please comply with my request.
But extra hot is 170 degrees.
Yeah! I'm sorry, does your job description entail arguing with your customers, thereby delaying the moment at which they receive the irresistible nutmeggy sweetness of the extra hot, no foam pumpkin spice latte they've been thinking about all day? I mean, God!
Ma'am, what would you like?
She doesn't want anything! She wants you to start making my extra hot, no foam pumpkin spice latte!
Yeah!
She used the card zombie noise in a fucking Chanel mix! Her mind!
This mix is hysterical.
There will be blood. Run for your life.
Go
on and say, go on and say your last goodbye.
There will be blood. Oh, some guy died. I'm over it! You burned the milk. Learn to make a pumpkin spice latte, you psychopath. Next time, I get you fired. Or worse.
I used to be called Kiki, and that was shit. And so I was with my friend trying to think of names, and I literally just had a white chocolate mocha from Starbucks in my hand. And that's always what I get, so that's my name now.
I think Mocha's really good at playing this character because Chanel Oberlin is a bitch.
This week is so fucking strong. I have no idea, like, who's gonna win? Who's gonna be in the bottom two? It's mental.
This look is very like, I feel like clown. Okay. I'm feeling a ruffle moment.
Okay.
My ass out.
Yes, ass. Yes.
Are we back?
She jiggles.
Oh, like, we're filming in here. Well, as Chanel Oberlin, I think I ruled school. I think I rocked it, darling. And next time I perform it, you know it'll be amazing. It was justifiable.
Okay.
But, you know, I was really proud of it. I, you know, don't know the results yet. So yeah, I really hope that I get a good score. I hope that I get the audience votes. I don't think I'm in the bottom two this week because like, mama, I was good. I got laughs, I got cheers. Mama, if I go home, robbery. Let's see. I would like to say, you know, do the competition. Wait, am I eliminated now?
No.
Watch Scream Queen season one, but not season two, because it's shit.
Things are getting harder for Mocha as they have ended up in the showdown.
Oh.
performance wise, I like to think that I just do whatever I want. Like, I'll do a number that's really campy or a number that's really serious.
So, Mocha's in the bottom two again. I'm not sure whether I think she deserves to be there this week, but I think, yeah, I mean, I don't think her act was the most inventive, so maybe that's why she's there. And also the glasses were kind of like obscuring her face. So I think that's why she's here.
Hate it when people lip sync with a microphone. I think it's so cringe. But keep going.
I guess it's not funny. Life is far from sunny.
She should be doing something to save herself, and she's not.
And again, if you're gonna just do a song, at least, like, do a song. I mean, I believe this is Barbara Streisand. There's no one here to tell me otherwise. It's like she could have done it grand. She could have, like, you know, had some sort of twist, take something off, put something on, cry a river. And instead she just, like, gripped onto that mic. And it kind of feels very, like, swan songy.
The fella said I've
She's lip syncing in front of a microphone.
How would I sound funny?
I think either sing or do a lip sync performance.
Funny girl.
That was sort of like the last bullet in her gun, because she had already bottomed three times, and so she was probably, like, exhausted by it, and she probably had nothing else left.
It's just so sad when I think about it, you know? It just, why did it have to be like this?
Mocha, this was a very flat, white performance.
I'm funny, talented.
Love her and love the choice, because it's kind of like, it's brave that she would go for, like, such a slow song. But then again, she bought a bag of flour and she didn't make no bread.
Commiserations to Mocha. You pass clean through. Oh, crap. I could never hold on to my caffeinated treat, y'all. Cut to the message.
My Gold Rush experience was shit. Everyone was shit. Everyone was average. I was the best. I shouldn't have gone home. Fuck the votes. Fuck the system. I don't think I should have gone home in Divas Week. I thought, like, that was my best performance of the competition. But I'm glad that someone like the Crossy eliminated me, because I really see her being, like, top three.
It's been a whole year since I did the Gold Rush, and I've learned a lot this year. I think that being in a competition environment really helps you learn about your craft and what you're doing right and what you're doing wrong. Doing the Gold Rush has really, like, helped me hone in on what I want to do and learn the things that I didn't realize I needed to learn in terms of performance. So, like, I would definitely recommend it to anyone that wants to do it, because you think you know what you're doing, but then when it comes down to it, if you're not getting the audience votes like me, you're clearly not doing something right. So it's really been an experience for me to take away and hone my craft and make myself funnier.
I may have gone home, but just like in primary school, my mum's not gonna pick me up for another 2 hours.
If you go digging for gold, expect to find mud on the way down.
If you could step back in time 5 years ago, what would you say to yourself?
Oh my god, what a little baby! If she could see me now, I think she would bully me. But you look great, skinny. You're just serving so much and I mean, the outfit's okay. We've got a little bit of scrap fabric around the neck. I don't know what we're doing that for. You're still doing the eye makeup. I don't know why, but the type of you're gonna serve in the future is gonna be so different to the kind of serving now, and I'm thankful for that.
Brilliant.
I don't know what I was saying.
much.
In honor of Divas Week, I'm going to be recreating some iconic Hun moments as a diva from Essex myself.
Woohoo! Date of birth, 15th of the 6th, 85. Make me a Gemini. And, what date of birth did I say now? 15th of the 6th.
Hi, my name's Nadine Coyle. I was born on the blah, 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 make me a Gemini. Oh, did I just say?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm great at this. Thank you.
Gorgeous.
Thank you very much.
You feel ready?
I'm ready.
You said that with some determination.
I'm ready.
Okay, whenever you're ready.
I'm ready.
Okay.
I'm ready!
Whenever you're ready.
I'm ready!
Do you want to do one more? And we already have the massive fail on the first one. I mean, not in the nicest way possible.
Yeah, oh, that's great. You won, Jane. Enjoy the money. I hope it makes you very happy. Dear Lord, what a sad little life, Jane. You've ruined my night completely. So you could have the money, but I hope you spend it and get some lessons on grace and decorum. Because you've got all the grace and decorum of a reversing dump truck without any tyres on. Hi, my name is Mocha. I'm on the Gold Rush Season 3 and these are my extra nuggets. I think I would say my series highlight is probably just not being in the bottom. Like, I was in the bottom nearly every week and like, it's stressful and I just could not handle it. And like, to finally breathe while stressed as SpongeBob, like, period. I would not change my Divas Week performance. Okay, I still perform that to this day. Like, I think I was low-key kind of robbed. My problem was, I just didn't have anyone showing up to turn up for me. Audience votes, you know, I would have been in the top if I had some friends in that room, but you know, I was not gonna pay my way. Like, if you do something you really love and something that's stupid and silly and it's just completely you, then like, it's gonna stick, it's gonna work. And like, if you overthink it, like I did every other week, you're just gonna be in the bottom. Dude.